Ooh, it actually has an engine. You know what Mopar stands for, right?
Mostly old parts and rust.
Yeah, the car's in rough shape, but wait till the crew hears Chuck's plans for it.
So what's the plan? I don't know if you want to hear the plan, to tell you the truth.
They want to hear it.
We got some work, okay?
Because we're doing two cars, we're looking for a way to save some money. So,
we're going to do a bare metal finish on this car.
On this car?
Bare metal finish.
A bare metal finish is exactly just that, maybe with clear coat over it. Most metal shapers, when they want to show off their level of skill they're at, with metal finishing, will leave it bare metal.
Normally, we spend 10 to 20 grand sending a car out for body and paint, right? I'd rather keep the money in-house, pay you guys to do the metal work right, than send it out and give someone else our money.
I don't know about you guys, but it's a little bit intense for me, because personally, I've never done any metal finish. That's a whole nother beast, you know what I mean? And you gotta have a special talent for that. So just as long as the welds can be seen and everybody's happy with that, I mean, I'm game, so.
I'm worried that we can't get it all looking presentable. It's a lot of work, it's a lot more than you think.
Actually, most of the panels are being replaced because they're so far gone, you can't properly fix them. So to do this job right, we're gonna replace almost all the panels.
I brought all the panels I could find from Seth's hoard to use them as replacements. Worst case, we buy a new panel, if we have to.
We've never done it before. I think it'll look trick. Has anybody seen a Dodge Charger in bare metal finish?
I'm not a muscle car guy. I dig older, vintage, custom cars. That's my thing.
Well, with this Charger, Chuck's doing the styling, so to speak, if you want to call it that, this whole bare metal thing, that's fine.
A bare metal finish is tough. You can see every flaw. You can't hide it with body filler, paint, or primer. But this is our chance to show people what kind of craftsmen we really are. I've pulled it off on bikes, and when it comes out right, it looks bitchin'. While the inner structure's getting blasted, Benny and I check out the panels we brought back from Seth's.
None of these are usable. They're ruined. Yeah, I mean, especially if you're still set on this bare metal finish. These are just not usable.
I am set on the bare metal finish, so.
If we were gonna paint the car, we could work with them, but
oh, yeah.
These are a disaster.
Well, changed my mind.
I've been working with Benny for years. I trust him. I respect his opinion. But the bare metal is the only way we're gonna save money to do the BMW.
Maybe we just buy new panels.
Well, isn't the expense of this gonna go way over your budget? I mean, that's what happens. You go over budget and it puts pressure on us to finish them quicker so we don't get so much wrapped up in labor.
The guys keep telling me what they can't do, but I know what they can do. They got it in them to do this, but it starts with Benny.
I need to have you on board, because if I don't have you on board, you're the shop leader. It all follows behind you.
Well, whether I agree or disagree, I'll always give you my best, so that's a given.
All right, that's all I can ask for.
So I pull the trigger on buying all new panels for the Charger. They're actually available through catalogs for about 500 bucks a pop, but it adds up quick, so I get Joe over here for a consult.
Hey!
How you doing, man?
What you doing, bud?
Stressing today, man, stressing.
Stressing? What's going on?
Have you sold anything yet?
I got one car sold.
Which one?
Sold a little Valiant. $2,000. That'll get you rolling, right?
You're killing me.
It's only been 10 days. A week and a half we've been back.
I need money. Are you kidding me? Joe sold one car. Oh, now I'm in trouble. All the panels that were at Seth's, that were supposed to be straight and in good shape.
Yeah, no good.
All beat up. Oh. I ended up buying a bunch of panels that I didn't plan on buying.
So now you're spending more money than you thought you were gonna.
Yeah.
No wonder you look stressed.
Yeah.
What'd Rick say?
He doesn't know. He has no idea. Well, Joe, look. I convinced him to do the bare metal because I told him we're gonna save 10 G's because it won't go to the body shop, it won't need to be prepped, it won't need paint. I need to get back some money, at least to pay for those panels for now.
That could happen, but you gotta give me time on it and you know we'll get it done.
Do me a favor. Don't call Rick. Call me when you find something out.
Okay.
At least first, but don't let on to him about the panels.
What am I, a marriage counselor? I gotta work these guys' problems out? I play dumb, I know nothing.
All right.
I'll take care of selling the cars, getting you the money, and I'll keep you in the loop.
I'm praying that Joe comes through for me, and fast, before Rick sees any of the budgets.
Well, the moment of truth.
Ready?
We got a countdown?
Five, four, three, two, bare steel?
Yep.
Oh, man.
How'd you guys do this?
Oh, trust me, this was some work.
I fought to have that bare metal finish, and when I saw the look on their faces and they saw that car, that just made my day.
Every body panel was replaced or repaired. We left it in bare metal.
Man.
Chuck had the car powder coated bumper to bumper.
To see the Charger in powder coat, I mean, I would have never thought about that. It just looks so wicked. Zed, pop the hood.
The suspension, the exhaust, on the underside of it looks like new. It's way past wheels and tires and body on this car. Amber got under the car and said, there's new frame connectors. Look at the suspension. I mean, what chick does that? There's car people, and there's really car people, and they are really car people.
All right, you ready to fire this thing up?
Yes.
Let's hear it. Yes.
She just looks so right in that car. From the hair to the lipstick, everything was cool.
I love that car. I'm gonna drive it every day.